And it's very grown up, Miss Cara. It's very grown up. It's Shakespeare.
It's huge.
How exciting.
For me, it's massive being in Stratford-upon-Avon.
Wow.
The birthplace of Shakespeare and the Royal Shakespeare Company.
How exciting. Is it a pinch me moment?
It is. I guess I never dreamed I'd be there, and I am. And I've got to say, it's taken a little bit of getting used to, because I've done a bit of theatre now, and I've got used to the prosarch and the normal sort of you're in the box, the audience is out there. But in this case, they call it the round,
right,
as Shakespeare would have performed
for sure.
His plays, and you are almost in the audience, which I'm not sure I like that.
I know, it's a bit strange.
It's taken a couple of weeks just to gauge how it all works, but
yeah.
I'm enjoying it now. It's
great. Oh, I bet you are. Is this the one that they're going to film as well? They're going to put it in cinemas too?
On the 14th of Feb, if anyone fancies Shakespeare on Valentine's Day.
Well, why not?
Why not?
It's
a comedy,
of course, a story
of love, and lots of love from all angles. And yeah, we're live to certain cinemas around the country. Live.
That's amazing.
On the 14th.
Mind you, are you used to these big live events? Because you did the whole kind of Sound of Music thing, which was fantastic.
Considering, I mean, we did all right. We got through it. And in hindsight, I'm so glad I did it. But I've got to say, it was the most nerve-wracking thing I've ever done.
Apart from this.
I always get nervous going on here.
I mean apart from your Shakespeare.
Apart from Shakespeare, yeah. The 4 minutes on the rain tops it. Oh, you're so scary.
Oh,
no, it was scary but brilliant. And I thought once I've done that I can do anything. So
of course, I try
and aim big.
But I've watched you from away back in EastEnders. I've watched you, I've gone to see you in the theatre and just watched your career on TV and now this. It's just going from strength to strength.
Oh.
But you work hard. That's the thing, you really do. You've served your apprenticeship.
Yeah,
I think now all the benefits are coming.
I know. I wanted to be an actress and I wanted to do as many different parts as possible. And if you work hard and you aim for things that maybe you think aren't in your reach,
just challenge yourself.
Absolutely. And every year I do something that I think, wow, my goodness.
But also,
why not?
With the added, if you like, that you have to overcome the fact that you're dyslexic.
Yeah.
And I know you've talked about that before. Mm. You did a brilliant documentary on that. It really was so helpful. I remember that got a massive reaction. And that's something, I think it's really good that you talked about that, Cara, because it affects an awful lot of people.
It does, and more people than I think I realised.
Yeah.
I think they say 1 in 9 people are dyslexic. I think it affects a lot more than that. Just to a degree, there's elements of dyslexia and everything. And with this especially, it's been a massive challenge because sometimes I struggle to, pick up a book and read normal English. So this is essentially a new language for me. But I really loved it. And once you understand, especially with Shakespeare, he's the greatest playwright of all time. And once you understand what's going on, it's just a joy. And there's nothing better. It's very indulgent.
I loved it at school. I was lucky enough to get a teacher who really enthused the class. If you get a teacher who can teach it properly and who can make you not scared of it or feel intimidated by it, then...
Yeah.
You've got a lifetime of joy
to
discover it. It's fantastic.
Exactly. And at the RSC, that's what they cater for. If you go and see one of their shows, you will understand.
You'll get it. You absolutely will. Have you had any time to watch Strictly?
I always watch Strictly.
Isn't it brilliant?
It is fantastic.
It's
so warm.
And,
I can't watch it when I'm doing the play, obviously, but I always catch up and I love
it. Look at you.
There I am.
There. Do you get a sort of a pang when you watch it sometimes and think, oh, that was such a great part of your life, you?
I was just about to say not at all. No, I do. I love watching it from the comfort of my home with a hot chocolate in hand and just knowing what they're all going through. It's such it's just a little challenge and one-off moment in life. When do you get to dance every
day? Exactly. Of course. Who have you got your eye on? Who do you like?
Well, I don't like to say because I think there's been a few shocks this year,
I have to say. Yeah.
I have been shocked. But they're all great. I don't want to do that.
Just give them all their seal of approval.
Good luck, all of you.
Good luck to all of the Strictlys. Any advice you would give to them, especially as we're getting into the later stages?
It's hard not to take it too seriously and just enjoy it.
Yeah,
it's
exactly. And listen, good luck with Mr. William Shakespeare. We should say what the play is called. I don't think we even
12th Night.
Did we not even say that?
At the RSC until February the 27th. And Christmas Carol's there as well.
Ah, brilliant.
Aid Edmondson. David Schofield, it's great.
Perfect for this time of year. Always a joy to see you.
Thank you.
Thank you, love. Thank you very much indeed.